Okay, then we start. I hope you're relaxed and full of fresh air and energy again. I have just two parts left for today's seminar. I guess that's enough about building types and building buildings. A short part about refurbishment, especially refurbishment from the outset when we reach higher in the roof. And people are still living inside. And then the second part is the outside ceiling systems, our solid membrane, which is they're comparable to the tapes. You know, there are so many different subroof membranes existing in the market. When you touch them, they feel the same. When you see the technical sheets, you can have the impression they are similar. They have passed all the tests, but they have different prices. But there is as well a big quality issue available, a big quality difference between the different products available in the market. But I'd like first to start with refurbishment. And here we start with the refurbishment from the outside. But when I drive here through Latvia and take a look at the one family of multi-story houses, I guess 50% of all the cases, people are living in the attic. They're using it for living space. And when they are living in the attic, you can only refurbish a house from the outside when you have to retire the roof, when you have to re-roof it. This is a difficult question. When you have to re-roof it, you have to think about how to achieve air tightness and how do I achieve the insulation thickness. How can I improve the energy efficiency of the house? We are working there with a special membrane, which can be installed around the rafters. But this is still the main situation. We have old timber finish, it can be humus, chimneys, it can be metal, it can be tiles, whatever. Then we have here a timber cladding, we have rafters, but we have insulation or no insulation depending how old the house is. And then we have on the inside different materials, chipping board or plastic material or timber, whatever. And people are living in there. And when we refurbish it, we remove all the existing material from the outside, and then we have the rafters visible, and here we are finished with it. And then we have the possibility to install an air tightness layer from the outside, all around the structure, so between the interior finish of the insulation and around the rafters, and so we can produce a continuous air tightness layer, and then we can finish the house again. So we can add, if we like, your insulation on the outside, if you try to board a polyurethane board or whatever, or we can just finish with a diffusion oven. And then we have the modern construction. If we work like this, we put a vapor membrane, an air tightness membrane, all around the construction and at the outside of the carrying structure to the cold side of the construction. We need to have a material which offers at the same time, in winter, completely two completely different building physical properties. Here on the outside, it's a very critical point because, of course, you can paint it like this. You can draw it like this, so you have sharp angles, you have a good connection between the membrane and the rafter, but in reality it's not possible. You have normally here some bulbs, and it may be that more air on the inside arrives in the cold outside area. Then we need here a membrane, which is open as a diffusion of the membrane. So if warm air arrives at this point, cools down, and you have the risk of coagulation, you need a membrane which can react from this humidity, open the structure, and let this humidity dry out to the outside. But only if we need most of the construction between the insulation material and the interior finish, we need a membrane which is at the same time diffusion controlling, because it must protect the insulation against the moisture from the inside. We achieve it with another intelligent membrane, which is slightly different from the Intello Ahead glue. It's called DataTop. And DataTop offers in dry conditions a C value of approximately 2 meters. In humid conditions, it is clearly more open than the Intello. It has a C value of 0.05 meters. Why that? Why can't we use Intello for going around the rafters like this? You can do, but in these areas where you have maybe 2, 3, 4 layers above each other, which you will have in a refurbishment situation, because refurbishment is always a little bit like clustering, how we call it clustering, like do it yourself. So you have a situation, you have more different layers over each other. It might be too tight. Here with 0.05 meter, the membrane is even when you have two layers above each other, open as a subwoof membrane of 0.50 meters. Good. So this is how it's working. In winter time, at the same time, the fuel retardant between the insulation material and the interior finish. But if we have a condensation risk on the outside, the dazotop can react on every part of the membrane, like intelligent membrane change molecular structure, and let it dry up to the outside. In summer, of course, when we have the back diffusion and we have more moisture, the construction than expected, a big amount of moisture can dry additionally out to the inside. The application is quite simple. Just cover the whole surface with a dazotop, let it overlap, because if it's raining, that the water can run down. We say fix it to the sides somehow. So you can do it with this thin stripes of plywood, or you can do it with some other help. Some people are using some plastic stripes, or using some rigid paper stripes, so different ways are possible. Important is to make the connection between the rafter and the membrane as good as possible to avoid the streaming waste from the inside to the outside. If you double the insulation, or if you put insulation from the outside later, put first the dazotop and then double the construction to transport this critical point to the warmer area of the construction. So the warmer it is at this point, the lower is the condensation risk. Here is how we fix it. You see here, we have these foldings. Impossible to do it without. Fix it just with a stapler. Another way to do it is you can do it when you have a big surface without any interruption. You can pre-glue the different membranes. In the plane, you have a good possibility to make the tape connection. Fold it like this, let it fall down from the roof, put it to the left and to the right, fix it with long lathing, and you have at once realized the building tightness and the air tightness. Be careful with nails. You have it every refurbishment situation. You can nail it down to the inside, then you have problems with the house owner. But better is when you just take a sharp tool, make it as sharp as possible, and install first 4 centimeters of insulation material, so all the nails are protected in this insulation layer. And then you have a smooth surface where you can install the dazotop. Yeah, overlays must be sealed with the tape, which is airtight and water resistant, of course, so from our products, the test container. Be careful in this pump. It's better when you fix it later with an additional lathing here, because here we found often leakages, because it's so difficult to install all these 3 layers on the same tension. Sometimes we have here one layer is open, the other is expanded, so it's always better to fix it mechanically later. Do penetrations with grommets. Yeah, critical point is how to realize the connection at the bottom. So we have to seal all around the rafters so that the warm air cannot stream out of the space. It must be sealed all the way around. Here in this case, they are doing it with the glue out of the cartridge, which is a good solution, but can work as well with tapes, if you like. And you must be sure that you seal around the rafters and you seal underneath as well. You see how good it is here. So it's a tricky part of the construction, but it must be realized airtight. Then another point is how can I realize the connection to the airtight layer of the wall. Here it's easy, you have a concrete, we call it a concrete part, so you can stick through. Here it's realized that they stick it just with the glue to the gable, to the timber gable, which is airtight, and around we have here as well this concrete part where we can stick to this. Okay, just a fast step into the refurbishment sector. The dazotop, I give it around, it's a very nice and smooth membrane, it's thin. Important is that it is green, because if it would be shiny as a tello, you need sunglasses by installing it, so the green color protects your eyes during installation. We use it a lot in Germany, so but it's the same as here. We have a lot of protected houses which are protected. You are not allowed to tear it down and change it. You have to rebuild it as they are. You cannot change the thickness of the roofs in some areas because this house is in a row. And even if the installation seems to be hard to go all around, up and down, up and down, up and down, then when you have done it one or two times, it's very easy. And we have companies who are only specialized in refurbishing from the outside, and they are very fast. Good. But another important point is the services. So when you have constructions where you are not sure, are they working concerning the buildings? Is Dazotox the right product? What do I have to respect? Which membrane should I use? Which tape should I use? You can contact Ivas, Arturs, and Rollins from Artiva. I guess you have the contact data, but you can pick up their business cards and lie around here. And then you can send them drawings, you can call them, and they will give you the advice which product is the right one. Because good products are only good when they are installed the proper way, of course. And this is one piece which is very important for us, the support for our customers. If you have very special projects, I can do movie calculations for you and contact forwards and you can forward it to me. So, we really like to improve the standard of building titans here in Latvia, and we do our best to support it. Good.